Hello everyone, now we are going to start our new concept and the name of the concept is Bootstrap. So till now we have studied HTML, CSS, to be specific pure HTML and pure CSS, and using the concepts, whatever the concepts we have learned till now, using those concepts we have built a mini project out of it. Basically we have built a hamburger mini out of it. Now what we are going to do is that we are going to study, you can say, a framework of styling, a framework of CSS, which is Bootstrap. Now the thing here is that when you study Bootstrap, now you might feel a little bit cheated, because till now whatever the things we have built it from scratch. But what Bootstrap will do is that it will give you some predefined styling to each and every component, and we have a predefined styling, we have some inbuilt CSS of Bootstrap. Now what we will do is that we will use this Bootstrap styling and we will build our own components, right? So what is the benefit, or what is one of the benefits of Bootstrap, is that first of all it will make our development process faster, because till now we have built everything from scratch, right? Let's say that I'm creating a button called as submit. Okay, now we know how this button will look like in HTML. The button will look like something in a squared fashion, and to be specific, to be honest, this button will not look good. Now for this button, what we used to do is that we used to give a external styling to this button, right? External predefined styling by us to this button to make the button look good, right? So what we did till now is that we have built everything from scratch. But one of the benefits of Bootstrap is that we don't need to build anything from scratch. Bootstrap has some predefined styling files and some JS files. What we will do is that, let's say this is our component, this is our document HTML index.html. Now what we will do is that we will connect this document to this predefined styling, and after that we will use this styling to build our own components, right? So what we are doing actually here is that we are basically, Bootstrap has defined each and everything for us. We are basically using it in order to make our site good. Okay, so this is one of the advantages of Bootstrap, right? We will see in this session what we are gonna study is, first of all we will study how to connect Bootstrap. After that we will see how components works, how components and grid layout, or basically how Bootstrap layout will work, right? These are the two things we are gonna solely focused on, and using these two things we are gonna build a site, basically a page out of it, using Bootstrap. Okay, so let us begin our session. Now what is the formal definition of Bootstrap? The formal definition of Bootstrap is that Bootstrap is a powerful feature-packed front-end toolkit which is used to build anything from prototype to production in just minutes, right? You have a design in mind. Now to implement that design, we are gonna use Bootstrap, and using Bootstrap we can build anything we want in just minutes, at least the front-end part of it. Okay, so let us begin with our session, and before we start how we can connect a Bootstrap and how we can use the components which are there in Bootstrap, let us talk about some of the benefits of Bootstrap. So the benefits of Bootstrap is, first point, it will make our development process faster, right? You can ask how it can make our development process faster is that, you know, if we use pure CSS, we have to give styling to each and everything, right? We have to define styling for each and every button from scratch, and we have to put a lot of mind into it. We have to put a lot of mind in building it, in thinking of it. Now what Bootstrap will do is that it has some predefined styling. It means that we don't need to think at all. We can use that styling to make our site good, right? This is one of the benefits of Bootstrap. It will make our process faster, and yeah, as I said that it has some pre-built components, and we are gonna basically use it. We are gonna import that pre-built components in our page and we are gonna use it. right? This is the basic understanding of Bootstrap. Now, one more thing you need to remember is that Bootstrap is very compatible for each and every browser. Right, what I mean by browser is we have Chrome, we have Safari, we have like a Brave browser, Microsoft Edge. So all these browsers support Bootstrap, right? So if we are using Bootstrap to build our site, then this might be a good option because it is like it makes our development process faster. It has pre-built components which we can use without thinking, and it is compatible with almost every browser out there, right? Okay, now let us talk about how we can connect it, how a Bootstrap site will look like. Okay, here what I'm gonna do is that I will search Bootstrap. That's all, I will search it. Now, when I search it, you can see that the first link is a Bootstrap link. You have to click on it and you will get the site of Bootstrap. So this is a site of Bootstrap. Here you can see that build fast responsive sites with Bootstrap. Anyways, we don't need to look all this. If you want to download Bootstrap, then you have to use this link to import all the Bootstrap things in your computer. Now what we are gonna do is that we will go to this documents. We are not gonna download Bootstrap in our computer. We can directly link, instead of downloading all the packages, we can link the Bootstrap file to our HTML document. We are gonna use this methods. Okay, so here you can see that in introduction we have all this. Okay, Bootstrap is a powerful future packed front end tool, whatever the things we have studied till now. Now to connect Bootstrap, we have to use this two links, right? This is a link. So using these two links, we can connect our Bootstrap to our HTML document. Okay, so here what I'm gonna do is that I will open my VS Code. First of all, I will open my VS Code. Now in the VS Code, I have opened my VS Code. I will remove all this. Let me remove all these things. I will create a new file called as bootstrap.html, right? So bootstrap dot html. I have created a file. Now in this I will like first of all copy my like boilerplate code. Now to connect my HTML document with the Bootstrap, what I'm gonna do is that I will copy this link. Here you can see that this is a link, right? So I'm gonna copy this link, style link, and I have to paste it in the head section. So in the head section I will paste it. Now after that we need to connect script tag also, because if we want functionality to our buttons, then we have to connect it with this script tag. We will study what is a script tag when we study JavaScript. I think the next lecture is going to be on JavaScript. So when we study JavaScript now, we will talk about what is script tag and how we can connect Java files, JavaScript files with our HTML documents, with our front end, all those kind of things. But yeah, so to connect Bootstrap, we need to like copy these two links. First of all, our styling link, this is a styling link. After that, this is a script link. So we need to copy these two links and paste it in our HTML document, right? So this like styling link will come right above the head tag, and this script tag will come right above the body tag. Okay, so after copying these two links, what we are gonna do is that we're gonna use the components of Bootstrap, that's all, right? Now, one more thing I want to mention here is that if you are building some large projects, then you might need to download Bootstrap, all the packages of Bootstrap. But no, right now we are not building anything huge. We are just like testing it out, how Bootstrap is working, how we can use different components. So for that, we are not gonna download it. If you want to download it, then you can go here, click on download, and you will get this file, right? So this is a like a source file for all the Bootstrap packages. Now when you click on download, your download will get started, and here you can see that your download will start. And here one more thing is that you can go here and you can click on download, and you can like download different versions of Bootstrap. right? We will study, when we study JavaScript, after JavaScript, we will study how NPM packages will work, what are the different NPM packages. Till now, we don't know anything about it, okay? So, the thing you need to remember is, to connect our Bootstrap, we have to copy this link tag. Where is my link tag? Right? This link tag and this script tag. By copying these two things, we can connect our Bootstrap. Okay, clear. Now let us go back to our PPT. How we are gonna proceed with this lecture is, first of all, we will study a layout. You know, in Bootstrap, we have two main things. One is layout and another one is components, right? So first of all, we are gonna study one layout, after that different components, again layout, after different components. Like this, we are gonna study in this lecture. So let us begin with our first layout. The name of the layout is container layout. So till now we have studied, okay, to write paragraph we will use paragraph tag, and after that we'll write, okay, I am Javed Hussain, I'm studying there and I'm a college student. Like this, we can write whatever we want. Okay, good, we are clear. Now we can write this same thing and make it even more beautiful using Bootstrap, using container layout. Let us see how it will work. If I talk now, then you will not understand. Let me show you. So here I will go to this website. In their website, you in the docs, we have each and everything in docs. Now if you want to study anything in specific, anything about Bootstrap in specific, in the document section you can study each and everything in detail. You can see that we have Z index, visibility, text, spacing, we have each and everything. If you want to study, then go and study each and everything by yourself. This will be one of the best practices you can do. Anyways, so our layout, where is our layout? So in the layout, our first component, our first is thing is containers. So using containers, we can create a container in our page, right? We know how to create a container. We use div element to create a container. Now similarly, we can create a predefined styled container using Bootstrap. Okay, so what I mean by predefined style container is, so here I will remove this. First of all, let me show you. I will remove this link tag and I will remove this script tag. Now let me create a div. Okay, I have created a div and I will write lorem ipsum. Basically, okay, let me copy this whole thing and copy. Paste. Okay, now let me run this site. You can see that I'm getting some default like lorem ipsum, like whatever the text I have like written, I'm getting this thing. Now you can see that there is zero margin on both left side and right side, and from bottom our text is coming at the right bottom line, at the right baseline. Now what I'm gonna do is that I will use container class. Here to use our container layout in Bootstrap, we have to use container class, right? Bootstrap comes with three different containers. One is container, next one is container break point, after container fluid, right? Okay, anyways, so to connect our Bootstrap, I'm gonna comment this out. I will comment this and also I will remove the comment here. Okay, now here I will give class is equals to container, right? Let me save it. Container, right? C-O-N-T-A-I-N-E-R, container. Now I hope the container spelling is right. Okay, this is a container. Let me copy this link. I don't want to make any spelling mistakes here. So yeah, now what I did is basically I have linked the document. There is a predefined CSS, you know, style sheet of Bootstrap, and there is a predefined some JavaScript bundle. And our HTML document is pointing to this predefined CSS, this predefined JavaScript bundle. Now, in this predefined CSS file, there is a class called as container. And in that, we don't know what is the styling. We don't know how the Bootstrap has given styling, all those kind of things. But what I did is that I have connected this div block to this predefined Bootstrap styling. Now, what will happen is that, let me go to the site. Let me show you. You can see that now there is a margin here. There is a margin on the left side. There is a margin on the right side. And the text font has changed. Like this, you can see that now it is looking kind of good, right? It is looking good when compared to the previous example. Let me show you. Okay, let me remove the class. Okay, now there is no class. If I didn't mention class, then I haven't connected it. I haven't connected this div block with my style, right? Now what will happen is that you can see that there is no margin, there is no styling, there is no font style. Right, I hope you are clear here. And this is looking very basic. But when I give styling now, when I give some class container, let me save it and go to the site. You can see that it is looking good. Right, it is looking good and presentable. This is a one of the advantages of Bootstrap. Now let us study in detail how many containers we are having. So we are having this many containers, container small. When you give container small now, it will occupy 100% width in small devices, in like phones or extra small devices which are having less than 576 pixel. In those screens, it will occupy 100% width. Okay, and after it, as the size increases, the document, the container will have this much width. Okay, clear. Now, yeah, this is the thing. Now, if I give container large or container, let me give container small and let us see what will happen. So here I will give container small. Let me save it and go to the document. You can see that it is looking kind of same, but when I click on inspect and let me connect this to this document. Okay. Now, when I click on inspect, you can see that expand this. Now you can see that it is occupying some width, but as the screen size is decreasing, now this page, this container is occupying 100% width, 100% page width, right? So here you can study about containers in detail, like for small screen, the container, all the containers will occupy 100% width. And as the screen size increases, we will get this much space for a particular container. I hope you are clear how we use containers, how we can import a particular component of Bootstrap in our styling. Now, the next component is buttons. Okay, so here from this moment, you will understand how Bootstrap is powerful. How much powerful is Bootstrap to be specific? Because, you know, when we give styling to a particular button, you can see that the button will look very basic. With pure HTML, it looked the worst. It will look the worst. But using Bootstrap, in just few seconds, we can make things very much beautiful. Right? And in Bootstrap, we have different types of button. This is a primary button. This is a secondary button. Success, danger, warning, info, light, dark, link. Right? This many buttons we are having. So let us see this in detail. So here in the document, in the documentation, you will find a component section. Right? In the components, you will find a link for buttons. Okay? Now, to import buttons in our like document, we have to write import class. Class is equals to button. And if we want a primary button, then we can give btn primary. If we want this button, then we can give btn secondary. So let me show you how we can import a button. First of all, I will write button submit. Without Bootstrap, let us see how the button will look like. Okay, so here you can see, right, this is my, where is my button? So this is my button, right? This is my button, very basic button, not looking good. Okay, now what we are gonna do is that we will give a class to this. So class is equals to btn. So I have given class is equals to btn to this particular button. Now let us go to the document. You can see that the button is looking something different because we have attached this button to a styling of Bootstrap. Now if I want to make it as a blue button, then I will write here, I will write btn primary. Okay, I will write btn primary. Now let us go to the document. You will observe that now the button is looking good without any, we are not giving any styling by ourselves. We are basically using the predefined styling, right? And in Bootstrap we have different types of buttons, right? These are not just the button. If you scroll down, you will see that these are the link buttons. If you want to convert an anchor tag into a button, then you can use this, right? Button primary, right? Anyways, and if you want to create some anime character buttons, outline buttons, then you can use this, like primary button. Let's say that when I hover over the button, I want this effect. So to create this effect, I will copy this class and I will paste it here, right? In the place of button primary, I will write btn outline primary. Okay, now let me save this and go to the document. So this is my document, right? Now when I hover over the button, I will get this outline, right? This is looking good, right? Like this, we can import different buttons. Similarly, we can, in the place of primary, we can give danger, right? Danger means we will get a red color button. Okay, so go to the document. Now you can see that your button is now red color. When you go to the button, your button will be having red color background. So the next component is badges. So what are badges is, you know, you might have seen in Instagram, on top of Instagram logo, we will get notification in red color. Those are known as badges, right? To show notification of a particular website, to show notifications of Instagram or YouTube or anything you want, we use badges. Okay, so let us see how we can use badges using Bootstrap. So in Bootstrap, we have a section called as badges, right? Now badges are like, we have different types of badges. Like this is a type of badge. To create this badge, what we are gonna do is that first of all, we have to create a button, right? First of all, we'll create a button. Okay, let me, here on top of body, I will create a button. Now I will give class is equals to button. And let me give the button as primary. Okay, primary. Now inside that, what I gotta do here is, first of all, I will give notification and span tag. Let me copy this batch. Okay, now I'm gonna paste it here. Now I have attached this. To create a batch, we need to use batch. To create a button, we have to use btn. Okay, now let us remove this. First of all, I will remove this thing and let us see how the button will look like. Okay, so here, go to the document. You can see that I got the batch, something like that. Okay, now let's say that I want to give some secondary or danger color, right? I want the text to be danger color. Okay, now go to the document. You can see that now we got the notification symbol, and this is one of the types of badges. Similarly, if you want to have this type of badge, then we will create a button, and inside that button, we will give some positioning to our text. Like this, we can use different types of badges, right? Similarly, we can also use here, let's say that after this button, I want to create a badge. So here I will write span tag, span class is equals to badge. And let's say that, okay, this is a batch. Give the text background as danger. And you can see that we got the batch, something like that, right? This is a batch. We got something like this. This is how we will use batches in Bootstrap. Now the next thing is alert. So alerts are nothing but, let's say that when you are in a website and you are filling a particular form, then let's say you have given something wrong in that. Now in that, what will happen is that you will get a pop-up, right? You will get a alert, JavaScript alert out of it. Now to create that, we use the component of alert. So in Bootstrap, we have a component called as alerts. Now we have different types of alerts. Again, primary alert, secondary alert, danger alert, and mostly we use danger alert because alerts are used to represent some kind of terror. Okay, so here to create a alert, first of all we have to write div and alert primary or alert secondary, something like that we have to give. Let's say it on top of website, on top of this site I'm creating a div, and in this I will write class is equals to alert alert, and background color, let me give the background color as danger. Okay, now here I will give this is a sample alert. Sample alert. Let me save and go to the document. You can see that here, let me see the document. Alert primary. Here I need to give alert primary, not background color. So here I will give alert primary or alert secondary. So here alert danger I am giving. Now let me save and go to the document. You can see that now I got the alert, something like that. This is a sample alert and the background of this alert is red color. Now if I want to remove this alert, then I have to add JavaScript. I have to add some functionality in it. So to add that, what we can do is that scroll down and you will have some JavaScript alerts, right? This is the different types of alerts. Now there is a JavaScript. Okay, I think this is a JavaScript alert, right? Now to import that, what we have to do is that we will use some JavaScript here, right? Button, something like that. So let me copy this and go to the document. Here I will paste it. Okay, now you can see that holy cow, you should check something in those fields and click on cross, the alert will go disappear. Now here one more thing I need to show is that if we remove script, let us say that I'm commenting script and going to the document. Now if I click on this cross button, now it will not go. Why? Because all the functionalities in our site is added by JavaScript. Now if you remove the script tag, then what will happen is that the file will not get connected with our Bootstrap JavaScript. That is why we will not get any functionalities in our page. So let me reconnect it with my JavaScript. Okay, now let me save and go to the document. Now when I click on cross, now the alert will disappear. Like this, we can use different types of alerts. Now the next component is group of button. Let's say, you know, you might have seen that in navbar we group some buttons like login, sign in or sign up buttons. So to create this group effect, we can use button group component. So here in Bootstrap we have button group component. Now to create different buttons, first of all we have to use a external div, and the name of the class is button group. By using this class we can group n number of buttons at once. Okay, so I will copy this and here I will paste it on top of my site. Okay, now I will give here login, create and sign up. Okay, I have given this three buttons. Now if you go to this document, now you will see that all these three buttons are grouped together. So to create this group effect, what we have to use, which class we have to use, is we have to use button group class. I hope you are clear with it, right? Now we can also change the colors of different buttons, like secondary, and let me make it as success will give green color, I guess. Yeah, you can see that we have created different color buttons. Right here I can give danger. Okay, danger. Like this, we can create different buttons, different grouped buttons together. Now the next component is navbar. So I think this might be a little bit complex for you right now, but if you use Bootstrap by your own, believe me, it will become super easy to you guys, okay? So navbar, what is a navbar is that, you know, whenever you go to any site, for example, let's say I'm going to the site of Bootstrap. Now, on top of Bootstrap, you can see that they have their logo. After it, a group of tags are coming, a group of anchor tags are coming in a line. After it, a search bar. So all these three things, all these things is known as navbar. So whatever the navigations you like you are giving to your site on top of the web page, that thing is known as navbar. And one more thing is that you can see that the buttons on the left side, these are also navbar, right? This is also a navbar, but this is a navbar on left, right? Navbar left, and this is known as main navbar of your site. Okay, got it. Now to use navbar, there is a component, okay, navbar. Now you can see that navbar requires wrapping, and the structure of this is kind of complex. First of all, we will write nav. After it, we will create a class with container to group all these elements together. After it, we will create different buttons. We will use different classes. So let me save this, and here I will write my navbar on top of it. Okay, now go to the document. You can see that we have imported our navbar here. We can have different things. This is a disabled button. We will talk about what is disabled button. So yeah, we can search anything we want here, but it will not work because we haven't defined JavaScript, right? Anyways, yeah, this is how we can use navbar. Now if you want to customize it, then what you got to do, just copy this code and customize it by yourself. Now if you want to study the code in detail, then go to the overall structure of this page. Now we have different types of navbar. Like this is a different type. This only logo is different type of navbar. Like this, you can import and like experiment with different types of navbars. Now the next component is carts. This is one of the most interesting like component we have seen. Now in websites, for example, let's say that we are going to a site, which site we want to go, okay, let me go to our site, let me go to my portfolio site. So here, Jabiron render, okay, this is my portfolio site basically. Now if you scroll down, you can see that my skills, web development, programming, machine learning, marketing and sales, right? So these three things are basically carts, right? You can see that these three, we call them as, these three divs as carts. We can create this thing also. We can create this thing also using Bootstrap, and this component, we call it as a card component. So here, let me go to the document, and you can see that we have a component called as cards. Where is the component? Yeah, card component. Now using this card component, you can like create your own card. So let me copy this here, let me copy this, and here okay, on top of text I will paste my card, and I can give my image. Let's say I'm giving image as Batman. Okay, now here let me move this. Okay, now let us see how my card will look like. Now you can see that I got the card something like that. Although this is not looking good, we are like just importing all the components, but yeah, like this we can create components in my card components in my VS Code. And we have different types of cards. Like scroll down, you can see that this is a type of card, this is a type of like another type of card, and here this card will have some like what you can call it fixed image size. So if I copy this card in the place of our previous card, you can see that I will give Batman again. Okay, Batman, and save the document. You will observe that it will have some fixed space. If I click on inspect, you can see that it will not change. Like this, we can create different cards in our document. Now, the next layout. Till now, we have studied almost important components, right? So the next layout is grid layout. So in grid layout, Bootstrap grid layout follows flexbox model. We studied flexbox, right? So arranging our components in the form of either row or column, we use flexbox, right? So what happens is that our bootstrap grid model follows flexbox model, right? It follows flexbox model, and each row is divided into 12 components. What I mean by components is that our row is divided into 12 equal columns, right? And based on this 12 columns, we can create anything we want out of it, right? So let me go to the layout. I will show you how this will work. So in the layout, we have grid, okay, grid. So grid series follows rows and columns anyways. Scroll down. Now, if I copy this thing now, okay, and let me remove all this, okay, let me remove for now, let me remove all these things. Now, I have pasted this column. Now, you can see that when I create this column, all these rows, right, this is like column 1, column 2, in a row, all the columns will occupy equal spaces, right? So let me go to the document. You can see that this is a column, this is another column, and this is column, right? Three columns, and these three columns will occupy equal spaces. If the whole screen with this 12, if the like columns are divided into 12 parts, right, 12 equal like sizes components, then the first column, this thing, will occupy four unit of space, and the second thing will occupy 4 unit of space, and the third thing will occupy 4 unit of space, right? Now if I want to manipulate, let me give the background color also. I will give the background color for this column. Let me give background color as green, which is success, and here the background color as danger, and background color as primary, okay. Okay, I have given this. Now you will observe that these three things are divided in three different equal space. Now, if I want to increase first column space, right? So this column 1, column 2, column 3, right now, they are occupying 4 unit space. Okay, now, if I want to increase the column 1 space or column 2 space or column 3 space, then what I have to use is here, I will give 5 and go to the document. You can see that now column 1 is occupying 5 unit of space. Now if I give, let's say 12, then what will happen? See, you can see that the column 1 is occupying the entire row, because our row is divided into 12 different units, and in that different units, however, all the columns will get like will go in, will occupy the space, right? Now if I give like 10, then the column 2 and column 3 will have one unit space. So let me show you. You can see that the column 1 is occupying 10 unit space, the column 2 is occupying 1 unit, column 3 is occupying 1 unit. So in a row is divided into 12 equal components. Now if you are giving for a particular row, for a particular column, if you are giving the entire row space, which is 12 units, then the next element will come in the next row. Like this we can use grid model. Now the next interesting concept is forms. So using Bootstrap, we can create like amazing fonts. So let me show you. So go to the forms. Now in the forms, here this is a sample form. First of all, we will write sample form after that this class is equal to MB3 is known as margin bottom. So if you scroll down, you can see that okay here. Now to create a form using Bootstrap, we have to write first of all form, after that div, class is equals to MB3. This MB3 is known as margin bottom 3. So what this will do is that it will make your font above from the web page. What I mean by above is that let's say that there is a site you are having. Now you don't want your site to come like your form to come like attached with the left side or attached with the right side or towards the bottom or towards the like top. You don't want this to happen. You want your form to come right in the center. Then what you're gonna use? You will use MB3, right? It will give 3 unit space from margin, both left side and right side, and from bottom it will give 3 unit space, right? This is the meaning of MB3. After that, you can use different labels, same as we create forms. Like we can write the same thing to create forms in our documents. We'll use the same thing. We know how to create forms. We have studied HTML, right? But all we need to do is that we have to add some classes. Like you can say that for input, we are adding a class called as form control. When we add form control, we will get this predefined styling. Like this, we can like, let me copy this and remove all this. Okay. Now let me save. Now go to the document. You can see that I got some predefined styling. Now when you click on it now, so here you can see, okay, let me zoom it out. Okay. Now when you click on the email, you will see that the whole input box is having some background color, some animation is coming here, right? So like this, we can create n number of fonts. You can like study in detail. Remember one thing I wanna tell you here. This session, Bootstrap session, which I have covered till now, I think this might be one of the boring sessions till now. Because if I talk about Bootstrap, what is there to talk about? Let's be honest here. Like, what is there to talk about? You know, in Bootstrap, I have shown you how to connect. I have shown you some buttons. I can show you how we can connect class. That's all. There is nothing. You as an audience, if you want to study Bootstrap, then the best way is come in Bootstrap website, go to the docs and study about them in detail, right? Experiment with it. Try creating your own fonts by copying this code. When you do this now, believe me, you will learn it. If I speak, if I keep on speaking, and if you are watching this, then it is no use, man. Believe me. Anyways, yeah. So we can create multiple forms like this. And if you go to like in forms, there is a form control. In form control, you can have different types of like password must be hidden like this. And also if you want to create some like select options, okay, whether you are from BTech or psychology or BSc or anything like that, if you want to create this sort of drop down, then you can use this. And the class you have to use it, form select class. Okay, now the next thing is check and radio buttons. So here we can use this buttons, check buttons, using Bootstrap, same, right? So, and range, we have range. Let's say that you wanna ask user how much you liked my services, then you can use range here. Okay, anyways, input group, footing label, validation will check, okay, whether your form has some valid URL or not. So what I mean by valid is, let me go to this document, okay, and paste this here. Okay, now I will write some name as Mark Otto, whatever, username D Jabir Hussain. Okay, now the city is, let's say, Kadapa, state, whatever, zip code, I'm not giving zip code, I'm just submitting. So when I click on submit now, if I entered something wrong, then it will tell me, okay, you haven't included this thing, include it. And until you include that thing, the form will not get submitted. Like this, you can also add different types of validation in your form. Okay, so till now, in this chapter, what we have studied is, first of all, I have shown you what is Bootstrap, how to connect Bootstrap, and how to use Bootstrap. Right, these are the three things which I have covered till now. I know this is one of the boring sessions because we haven't studied anything logic. We haven't studied or built anything from scratch. You know, in CSS, we were studying about concepts, but here we are becoming somewhat a robo, right? We are just copy and pasting. But yeah, that is the thing. You need to remember that in development, whenever you are building real-time projects, you're not building anything from scratch, right? You sometimes, maybe, yeah, sometimes if your project is so out of the box, if your project is so unique, then you will go for vanilla CSS. Until and unless, we are going to use these components, man. Right, this is all. And one more thing I want to point out is that, you know, by the end of this session, by the end of this course, we will study about Tailwind CSS. Right, we will study about Tailwind CSS, and Tailwind CSS is very similar to Bootstrap, but it is kind of more advanced. We will study when we complete backend and databases, but till now, yeah, this is about Bootstrap. With that being said, the next session is going to be on JavaScript, and JavaScript session is going to be amazing. Okay, so with that being said, I will see you in the next one.